Father God, we ever be so careful to give you all the honor, glory, and the praise. In Jesus' name, let every heart say amen.
Amen.
Pick up your Bibles. Go to Romans chapter 8. And we are going to read 34 and 35. How many of y'all happy to be here tonight?
Right.
Let God know that you're ready. Let God know that you're happy. Give him some praise, y'all. And it reads, who is he that condemneth? It is Christ that died, yea, rather, that is risen again, who is even at the right hand of God, who also maketh intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? You may be seated. Tonight, I want you to look at your neighbor again. See, some of y'all wasn't here last night. But tonight you're here. I want you to look at your neck. Y'all look at y'all neighbor. All right. Look at your neighbor. And say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
You won't.
You won't.
Be able.
Be able.
To separate me.
Separate me.
From the love.
From the love.
Tonight, that who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Watch this, I'm gonna break it down to you.
Come on now.
Number one says, us from the love of Christ shall what? Tribulation? Watch this. We go through trials and tribulations every day.
Amen. Amen.
Watch this. Young people, this is what I want you to understand tonight. You say the same thing that the grown-up said. Said, neighbor.
Neighbor.
I said the young people. And y'all will say it like you really mean it. Right? Neighbor.
Neighbor.
All right.
Teacher.
Teacher.
I'm speaking in terms of going to school too. Teacher.
Teacher.
You will not.
You will not.
Be able.
Be able.
To separate me.
To separate me
from the love,
from the love
of Christ.
Of Christ.
Now you take that to school and tell them. Nobody shall be able.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Let me tell y'all young people something. They go through trials and tribulations.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They may not understand what they're going through, but yet they go through too.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, let me start it. Or distress. Watch this. Take the I out the way. I want you to put that S straight. Ooh. Boy, y'all didn't get that picture. They call it repression. Stress. Let me tell you something. When you're worried about something, you get stressed out. The Bible lets you know. Don't worry. If you don't wear it, why you pray?
All right.
The Bible speaks.
Lord have mercy.
Well, let me tell you something. We get persecuted all the time.
Yeah.
Not only us. I'm talking about the pastors. But y'all too. People on your job.
Yeah.
Try to persecute you.
Yeah.
They talk down on you.
All right.
They go and tell lies on you.
Yeah.
They try to do everything to what? Separate you.
Amen.
They try to separate you from the love of Christ.
Amen.
Are y'all getting this?
Amen.
Then it says, or faith. Uh-oh.
All right.
Watch out. Come on now.
Let me tell you something. When I was in Texas, living there, that's my hometown.
All right.
I didn't have nothing.
All right.
Say that,
man. I raised a little infant, my son, by myself.
All right. Say that.
All right. All right.
Didn't nobody give us nothing. I was broke.
All right.
But watch this. Famine means nothing to eat, baby.
All right. All right.
Amen.
All right.
Y'all getting what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And guess what? There's in other countries, people are hungry every day.
Yeah.
Jesus already told you there was going to be famine, pestilence, everywhere.
Everywhere.
Kids, hang with mama and dad. Because famine means if you think that you're grown enough to step on your own and think that you can take care of yourself on your own, you got another thing coming.
Yeah.
But watch this.